Hey everybody, Chris here. Today I'm sharing an episode from one of my other podcasts, Hip Hop Taught Me Everything. Since I've referenced A Tribe Called Quest so many times on this podcast, and Nate never gets the reference, it seemed like a logical choice to share this episode. A Tribe Called Quest taught me authenticity. Most of the episodes of Hip Hop Taught Me Everything, literally every other episode in season one, has beats made by Devin Dabney, but this one is all me, mostly because I'm old and steeped in this type of boom bap. After each of this style of episode, which we call lessons episodes, Devin and I record a separate episode called Liner Notes, which are long-form conversations where we go deep into the history and making of the song. In this case, we break down the samples used and discuss how the sampling on this album, the low-end theory, changed the game for everybody. Also, if you listen to Hip Hop Taught Me Everything on Spotify Premium, then immediately after a lessons episode, the full song that we're learning the lesson from will play. It's actually one of my favorite things to listen to these lesson episodes as a setup for the songs that I love. If you enjoy this one, go check out Hip Hop Taught Me Everything anywhere you get your pods, subscribe, and leave us a review. And I'll see you again soon. Let's get into it. It's time to build. Will Smith famously said, "Basketball courts in the summer's got girls there." And in the summer of 1991, those girls were listening to Color Me Bad, Gerardo, and Marky Mark. So I was too. Luckily, I had discovered a late night radio show by DJ Icy D, Gangstar, Public Enemy, Chubb Rock, EPMD, it was all there. And for the price of an empty cassette and some lost sleep, it could all be mine. But the cyclic 3 months of freedom came to a close, and I had to figure out how to get that music and get sleep. Insert the Maxell cassette, hit play, record, pause, set the alarm. Alarm goes off, roll over, release the pause button, go back to sleep. On the bus the next morning, there would be 60 minutes of hip-hop untouched by Billboard charts. Slip on the headphones, eyes closed, hit play on the Walkman. And immediately, my little world exploded. I'm Chris Hampton, and this is how A Tribe Called Quest taught me authenticity. I'd heard their first album, People's Instinctive Travels in the Paths of Rhythm, but wasn't entirely sold. I couldn't quite put my finger on it. Something was missing. Whatever it was, by the time they walked into the studio and queued up the now iconic samples from Grover Washington, Biz Markie, The Average White Band, and Minnie Riperton, they had figured it out. And they had absolutely mastered it. They waste no time in letting us know that they're moving forward by looking back. A dangerous proposition when done without a critical eye toward nostalgia. However, when the rearview mirror is used simply to guide the travel, knowing where you came from is a valuable ingredient.
Yo, Fife, you remember that routine that we used to make spiffy like Mr. Clean? A tidbit, a smidgen. I don't get the message, so you gots to run the pigeon.
The standard-setting song for call-and-response hip-hop in a genre essentially built on call-and-response.
Can I kick it? Yes, you can!
Check the Rhyme was the first time we heard Fife Dawg really go for it, being his street corner, battle-rapping, confident, swaggering self. The origin of what would quickly become a hip-hop fact. There's nobody better in all of hip-hop, hell, in all of music, than the 5-foot assassin at kicking off a verse.
Now here's a funky introduction of how nice I am. Tell your mother, tell your father, send a telegram. I'm like an energizer, cause you see I last long. My crew is never ever whack because we stand strong.
Tribe was Native Tongues, and somehow I'd gotten the idea that because Native Tongues was about positivity, open-mindedness, and Afrocentricity, then they must be above the usual ego-fueled braggadocio of hip-hop. And here was Fife, loudly, proudly, unabashedly talking his shit.
You'd be a fool to reply to Fife as not the man, cause you know, and I know, that you know who I am.
Half a verse in, and he was right. We did know. Because he didn't try to be someone he wasn't. Because who we got was just who he was. Fife treated every verse like he was in a cipher back on the Boulevard of Linden. And he knew he had that heat that would make every MC in the circle lean closer so they didn't miss a single syllable. And we're still leaning in. Almost excuse you if you assume that Tribe Called Quest was a duo, Q-Tip and Fife Dawg, or a trio with Ali Shaheed Muhammad. Almost excuse you. But there were four. Shaheed, quiet and humbly introspective even now, mostly played the background working on production and DJing. And the fourth member, Jerobe White, was following his passion for cooking, but remained a spiritual advisor, a Bundini Brown to a Muhammad Ali. Sometimes it's what you don't see that shows you everything. Tribe was quickly becoming the most celebrated group in hip-hop, and two of the members chose to remain out of the spotlight. Why? Because that's just who they were.
Okay, if knowledge is the key, then just show me the lock. Got the scrawny legs, but I move just like Lou Brock. With speed, I'm agile, plus I'm worth your while.
Q-Tip seems to be telling us, we may have some shortcomings, but we adapt. And we know how to do this. It's who we are. We got it from here. And sitting there, on the school bus, in my own little world, I believed him. How could I not? It was very obvious, a few words in, that is just who he was. And then, as if he knew exactly the question that would come from a 16-year-old kid in Cincinnati with too many interests to fit into any one clique, who was having trouble at home and was only a couple of months from getting sent to juvenile detention, and felt like he was living in a world he could not understand and that did not even try to understand him,
how far must you go to gain respect? Well, it's kind of simple. Just remain your own, or you'll be crazy, sad, and alone.
Be authentic. That's enough. You don't need to dress like them, or talk like them, or do the things they do, whoever they are. That's just not it. Clean out your ears and just check the word. Remain you, and the people whose respect is worth having will give it. Stay on point, and always represent, represent.